हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू श्री क्लासेस, लेक्चर नंबर 3, प्रोबेबिलिटी. इन दिस सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट ओनली फ्यू क्रिटिकल सम्स विच विल बी सेलेक्टेड फ्रॉम आरडीएस आरएसए एज वेल एज फ्रॉम आईसीएसई 10th स्टैंडर्ड न्यूमेरिकल्स. इन आईसीएसई 10th न्यूमेरिकल्स देर आर कपल ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल्स विच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड दो सेम न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑल्सो हैड अपियर्ड इन मेनी ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन कंडक्टेड बाई योर स्कूल्स. And therefore, I need to discuss all those. Here, the sum goes like this. 3 coins are tossed. Find the probability of getting at least 2 heads, at most 1 head, and no tail. So, let us solve this one. When 3 coins are tossed, we know the total number of possible outcomes. Solution. Total number of, I'll write it as number of all possible outcomes. Number of all possible outcomes is equal to n of s is equal to 2 to the power 3, which is 8. And these outcomes are nothing but, let me write it as a sample space. How to write this one? HT TH HT TH HH and TT. Repeat. HT TH HH and TT. Once add behind T. So this is a sample space, and the number of elements in the set of sample space are 8. So total number of possible outcomes is 8 here. To solve the first one, at least 2 heads. Let event E equals at least 2 heads. Therefore, outcomes favorable for E, What are the favorable outcomes for E? That is at least 2 heads. Count. See, the meaning of at least 2 heads means maximum there is no restriction, but minimum 2 heads should be available. So what are those outcomes? First one, HHT. HTH. At least means, can I consider this one? Yes. HHH. Because at least 2 heads. So maximum no restriction, minimum 2 heads. This one not possible. This one not possible. This one not possible. This one possible. THH. Any other thing? That's all. So number of favorable outcomes for event E is 1, 2, 3, 4, and therefore probability of getting at least 2 heads is equal to outcomes favorable for 2 heads, outcomes or number of outcomes, rather than outcomes I should say number, basically number of outcomes favorable to E divided by number of all possible outcomes, which is equal to number of outcomes favorable to event E is 4 divided by all possible outcomes is 8, therefore 1/2. So this is the first answer. Second one, at most 1 head. So here let event F is equal to getting at most 1 head So let us list down the outcomes for F. The outcomes for at most one head. See here, at most means maximum limit is one head. What about minimum? There's no restriction. Therefore, it can be zero head also. Please remember, when I say at most one head, minimum heads zero. That means all the tails also can be considered? Yes, possible. So let us list down. At most one head. Is this one true? No. Two heads are there. Two heads are there. Two heads are there. One head. HTT. Next, one head. THT. TTH. THH not there. I have to consider TTT also. Why I should consider? At most one head, meaning minimum zero heads, it is allowed. And therefore, N of F equals 4. Therefore, probability of F is equal to N of F divided by N of S, which is a sample space, 4 divided by 8, which is also 1 by 2. Are you aapko samajh mein? Getting at most one head. Is this question there? At least two head, at most it is not there in this case. Fine, one more is there. No tail, third one. Let event G equals no tail, getting no tail. So let us list down the events. No tail. Tail should not be there. That means only triple H. H, 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 which is 1. And therefore, probability of G is equal to N of G. I'll write N of G also here. It is not N of G. It is this set. Therefore, implies N of G equals 1. So P of G, probability of G is equal to N of G divided by N of S, which is equal to 1 divided by 8. This is the answer. So make a note of this one. Second question. Tickets are numbered from 2 to 25. Find the probability that the ticket numbers are multiples of 3 or 7, multiples of 3 and 7. Multiples of 3 or 7 means all the ticket numbers which are multiples of 3 should be added to the ticket numbers which are multiple of 7. R means addition, and means it is the common one, the common multiples of 3 and 7. Here multiples of 3 plus multiples of 7 are the outcomes favorable for multiples of 3 or 7, and means only the common multiples. So you must be aware of the fact that the difference between R and AND. Okay, so the tickets are numbered from 2 to 25. What are the total possible outcomes? Total number of cards is equal to total number of cards are nothing but total number of possible outcomes. Total number of cards is equal to 25 minus 2 plus 1. This I have explained, which is 25 minus 2, 23 plus 1, which is equal to 24. And therefore, number of all possible outcomes is equal to 24. I hope you understood. How did I calculate the total number of cards? 25 minus 2 is 23 plus 1 is 24. Now, number of all possible outcomes, we got it. So I can refer this as N of S also, implies N of S is equal to 24. S represents a sample space. The first one. So let event A equals multiples of cards which are the multiples of 3 or 7. So therefore, set A contains all the numbers from 2 to 25 which are the multiples of 3 or 7. So which are those things? Multiples of 3 3 6 9 3 6 9 12 15 18 21 24 24 27 comes? No, because numbers are marked from 2 to 25. So I should start with the 3, which is the first multiple, and ends with card number 24, card which on which the return number is 24. So these are the numbers which have been written on the cards and which are multiples of 3. Now for this one I have to add the multiples of 7 also, but while adding, if the multiple of 7 is over here, that should not be considered, isn't it? Okay, so let's see now. 7 directly 7, 14, 21, but 21 is here already, and therefore I should not consider 21 once again. Therefore I will erase this. Any other multiple of 7? 7 threes are 21, next is 28, but limited to 25 here. So these are the only two outcomes which are multiples of 7, that's all. So n of a equals 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 10. So probability of a getting a is equal to n of a divided by n of s, which is 10 divided by n of s is 24, which is equal to 2 divided by 5 divided by 12. This is the answer. 2 5s are 2 12s are 24. So probability of a, that is probability of getting the multiples of 3 or 7, is this one. Second one, let event b equals card numbers having multiples of 3 and 7, multiples of 3 and 7. So let us list down the outcomes that are favorable for multiples of 3 and 7. Already we have taken out 3 or 7. Now when I say 3 and 7, any other common multiples are there for both 3 and 7, you have to pick up such multiples. So 21, only 21 is the multiple of 3 and also 7. Any other thing? 7 2s are 14, 7 3s are 21. So 14 is not divisible by 3 and 21 is divisible by 3 as well as by 7, and therefore only one outcome, which is 21. So therefore implies n of b equals 1. Therefore probability of b is equal to n of b divided by n of s, which is 1 divided by n of s is how much? Total number of cards, 24. So make a note of this. Third problem goes like this. 1000 lottery tickets are sold for 5 prizes. Ashok buys a ticket. Find the probability that he wins a prize. So if 1000 tickets are sold, number of total number of tickets sold, total number of tickets sold equals 1000. Number of prizes is equal to 5 implies number of favorable outcomes to win prize equals 5. Therefore probability of winning a prize is equal to number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of tickets, which is equal to 5 divided by 1000 0.005. See, he has even though purchased only one ticket, the probability is not 1 by 1000. Please remember over here, because against one ticket, how many prizes he can win? 5 prizes. And therefore, even though he has purchased one ticket, the number of favorable outcomes for winning up of a prize is 5 outcomes here. And therefore, 5 divided by 1000. Make a note of this. This is one of the important problems. Find the probability of getting 53 Sundays in a non-leap year and in a leap year. So, solution. First one, non-leap year. So, in a non-leap year, you have 365 days, which is equal to 365 divided by 7 weeks, which also can be written as 52 weeks plus 1 day. I can write like this, 52 weeks plus 1 day. Is it right? 365 days in a non-leap year is 52 weeks plus 1 day. Therefore, 52 Sundays for 52 weeks. 52 Sundays for 52 weeks. Remaining one day can be Monday to Sunday. Isn't it? Monday to Sunday. Remaining one day can be Monday to Sunday. Is it clear for all of you? 52 Sundays for 52 weeks and remaining one day can be Monday to Sunday. Out of this Monday to Sunday, Sunday can come only on one day, isn't it? And therefore, here I'll write the total number of possible outcomes is for this one day, which can be from Monday to Sunday, which is 7 outcomes are available. Out of 7 outcomes, Sunday can be only one day, that is a favorable outcome. Therefore, probability of 53 Sundays will be 1 by 7. I hope you are able to understand. Let us see. Therefore, 52 Sundays for 52 weeks and remaining one day can be Monday to Sunday. Therefore, number of all possible outcomes is equal to 7. Why 7? That one day left can be Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. It can be like that. Whereas number of favorable outcomes for Sunday is only 1, because out of 7 days, Sunday can come only one day. So 1 here. And therefore, probability of 53 Sundays is equal to this 1 out of 7 is the probability, 1 divided by 7. So I hope you are understanding here. It is important. It is not that 1 divided by 365, it is not like that. Here 52 Sundays will definitely come. This one day matters whether 53 Sundays can appear or not. So this one day can be Monday to Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 7 days. So out of this one day can be 7 days, out of which outcomes favorable for Sunday is only one day, and therefore probability of getting 53 Sundays is nothing but 1 divided by 7. So in a non-leap year where 365 days are there, the probability of getting 53 Sundays is equal to 1 by 7. Next, in a leap year, the number of days in a leap year are 366 days, and therefore 366 days is equal to 366 divided by 7 weeks, which is equal to 52 weeks plus 2 days. See here, 52 weeks into 7 days gives you 364 days. So 365 days will have 364 days, which is 52 weeks plus 1 day. In this case, 7 days into 52 weeks gives you 364 days. Remaining 2 days will be there over here in a leap year, because it contains 366 days in a year, not 365. In a regular year, 365 days, but in a leap year, 366 days. Convert it into weekend days, 52 weeks plus 2 days. Now, 52 weeks plus 2 days. Now, so leap year has 52 weeks. So 52 weeks contain 52 Sundays. Sundays. Okay. So outcomes favor the total number of all possible outcomes for 2 days are total number of all possible outcomes for 2 days is given by total number of all possible outcomes for 2 days is given by Monday, Tuesday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday, Friday, Saturday, and Saturday, Sunday, and Sunday, Monday. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Aapka samajh mein aa raha hai? The 2 days which are there, what are all the possible combinations for those 2 days? It can be Monday, Tuesday, or Tuesday, Wednesday, or Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday, Friday, Saturday, Saturday, Sunday, and Sunday, Monday. How many possible combinations? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And therefore, total number of possible, this is equal to 7, I'll write. Total number of all possible outcomes for 2 days is 7. Outcomes favorable for Sundays. Outcomes favorable for Sundays. I'll write number of itself directly. Number of outcomes favorable for Sundays is equal to list down. Where are Sundays in this case? Saturday, Sunday, and Sunday, Monday. Only 2 are there. Saturday, Sunday, and Sunday and Monday. These are the 2 outcomes, which is equal to 2 here. And therefore, probability of getting 53 Sundays in a leap year is equal to outcomes favorable for Sundays divided by total number of possible outcomes. Therefore, required probability of 53 Sundays in a leap year is equal to 2 divided by 7. Aapko samajh mein aa raha hai? So here it is 1 by 7, 2 by 7. Now listen, instead of Sunday, I can consider here what is the probability of getting 53 Mondays. Same process. 53 Tuesdays. Same process. So what is the probability of getting 53 Saturdays? Same process, 1 by 7. What is the probability of getting 52 weeks contains 52 Sundays. Okay, I can also write, just a moment, I'll explain to you. And remaining 2 days, and remaining 2 days can be total number of possible outcomes. You can write like this. Okay, what I was saying, something like, you know, okay, here 53 Sundays is the question. Instead of 53 Sundays in a leap year, it can be 53 Mondays, Tuesdays, what I say, Thursdays, Friday, Saturday. Same process, 2 by 7 is the answer. So make a clear note of this, finding the probability of 53 Sundays in a non-leap year and a leap year, which is 1 by 7, 2 by 7. Make a note. Here the question goes like this. A jar contains 54 balls that are blue, green, and white. If one of the ball is picked up, then the probabilities are given. That is, probability of getting a blue ball, P of B, is 1 by 3. Getting a green ball is 4 by 9. Find the number of white balls. So how do you find out? You know the probabilities. You do not know basically the number of blue balls, green balls and all. You have to find out the white ball. Isn't it? So solution. Let the number of blue balls be number of green balls be g, number of white balls be w. Therefore, total number of balls b plus g plus w is equal to 54. Now, probability of b is equal to number of blue balls, that is b, divided by total number of balls, 54. What is probability of b? Given is 1/3. So 1/3 equals b by 54, implies number of balls of blue is equal to 54 divided by 3, which is equal to 18. So therefore, number of blue balls equals b equals 18, correct? Correct. Similarly, probability of green ball is equal to number of green balls divided by total number of balls. What is probability of green ball? 4/9. 4/9 is equal to g by 54, implies g equals 4 × 54 divided by 9, which is equal to how much? This is 6, 24 balls. Therefore, number of green balls is equal to 24. Now, you know already b plus g plus w is equal to 54. Find out w. B plus g plus w is equal to 54. So w equals 54 minus b minus g. So 54 minus blue balls 18 minus 24, which is equal to 54 minus of 24 to 42, which is 12 balls, correct? Therefore, number of white balls. Therefore, number of white balls equals 12. I hope it is correct. 12 only. 54 minus 42 is how much? Check it. Okay. Alternate method. Listen very carefully. Here itself, I'll try to do it. Alternate method. See whether you can understand. Probability of b plus probability of g plus probability of w is equal to 1. See here, probability of b plus probability of g plus probability of w is equal to 1. That is, probability of all elementary events should be equal to 1. That is by property. So probability of w white balls is equal to 1 minus into bracket probability of b plus probability of g, which is equal to 1 minus probability of b, 1/3 plus 4/9, which equals 1 minus 1/3 minus 1/9, okay, 4/9, okay, 4/9, which equals 9 is the LCM. So this is 9 minus 3 minus 4. So probability of w is equal to 9 minus 7, which is 2 by 9. But we know what is the probability of b is equal to. Here I'll write, we know that probability of w is equal to number of white balls divided by 54. So w is equal to probability of w into 54. Probability of w is 2/9 into 54, which is 2 into 6, which is 12. So number of white balls is equal to 12. There are a couple of methods. I mean, you should know also, instead of calculating the number of balls of green and blue like this, based on the probability given, you can also calculate like this, so that this also confirms that the probability of all elementary events of an experiment is 1. So this also you can make a note of this. Very typical sum. A bag contains 5 red balls and some blue balls. If the probability of drawing a blue ball is 2 times that of the red ball, find the number of blue balls. So let number of blue balls is equal to x. Therefore, total number of balls in the bag is equal to 5 red plus x. Number of red balls also, I'll write it. Number of red balls is equal to 5. Number of, let the number of blue balls be x, number of red balls is 5, therefore total number of balls in the bag is 5 plus x. Now p1 equals probability of red ball is equal to number of red balls divided by total number of balls, which is 5 divided by 5 plus x. p2, so probability of blue ball is equal to x divided by 5 plus x. Correct? No? Probability of getting a red ball is number of red balls divided by total number of balls. Probability of blue ball, number of blue balls, which is x, divided by total number of balls. Now, according to question, see here, probability of getting a red ball, if the probability of drawing a blue ball is 2 times that of the red balls, that means p2 is equal to probability of blue ball is equal to 2 times probability of p1. So what is p2? X by 5 plus x. X by 5 plus x is equal to 2 times, what is p1? 5 divided by 5 plus x. 5 divided by 5 plus x, which is equal to 10 divided by 5 plus x. So this cross multiply, x into 5 plus x is equal to 10 into 5 plus x. Let us solve this one now. 5x plus x square x into x square is equal to 50 plus 10 into 5, 50 plus 10x. So x square plus 5x minus 10x minus 50 equals 0. So this is x square. 5x minus 10x is minus 5x minus 50 equals 0. 10 into 5 is 50, minus 10 plus 5. So x square minus 10x plus 5x minus 50 equals 0. Take common, x minus 10 plus 5, x minus 10 equals 0. So x minus 10 equals 0, or one more step, I'll write it, it is confusing otherwise. X minus 10 into x plus 5 equals 0. X minus 10 equals 0. X plus 5 equals 0. X equals 10. X equals minus 5. Minus 5 is discarded because number of blue balls cannot be negative, and therefore number of blue balls is equal to x equals 10. Clear? Note down. Very typical question. A number x is chosen from 1, 2, 3 and y is chosen from 1, 4, 9. That means x can take 1, 2, 3 values and y can take 1, 4, 9 values. Listen to the question. What is the probability that the product xy, this into this, of the two numbers is less than 9? Kaisa karoge? What are the possible number of outcomes here? We need to have the product here, and the chosen number should be x should be amongst this, y should be like this. See, I'll create a matrix over here in order to understand the total number of outcomes and also their product. I'll take it. So let us select the numbers x from here and let us select the numbers y from here. X numbers belong to, or x can be chosen from 1, 2 and 3, and y is 1, 4, 9. So now let us, this is a matrix here. The product I am taking, because I am taking product, see, the question can be product or sum or difference. Jaisa question pucha jayega, aisa aapko karna padega. XY is the product over here. So I am multiplying this one. 1 into 1, 1. 1 into 2, 2. 1 into 3, 3. 4 into 1, 4. 4 into 2, 8. 4 into 3, 12. 9 into 1, 9. 9 into 2, 18. 9 into 3, 27. These are the products. Agar tumko x plus y diya to, this plus this, this plus this, this plus this. This is how you have to write the numbers there. So I have the listed here the products. What are all possible outcomes over here? 3 plus 3 plus 3, which are 12 here. 12 are the total number of possible outcomes. 9 possible outcomes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Sorry. 9 total possible outcomes. So number of all possible outcomes is equal to n of s is equal to 3 6 9. Then outcome, let A be the event which is the product xy less than 9. A is an event and where the product xy should be less than 9. So select here equals less than 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, that's all. 12 is greater than 9. 9 is equal to 9, but it is less than 9 here. It is not equal to. If it is less than or equal to 9, I have to consider. Now it is less than 9, 9 I cannot consider. 18, 24. So only 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. These are the favorable outcomes for the product xy to be lesser than 9. And therefore n of a equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. And therefore probability of a, what is a basically? A is an event whose product is less than 9. So probability of a, that is product of probability of getting product less than 9 is equal to n of s. N of a is 5 divided by 9. Clear? Make a note. This is a typical sum appeared in 2016. There is a spinning wheel and a player spins the pointer 2 times and obtains the outputs, the outcomes respectively as A and B. When he spins this 2 times, he obtains the outputs as the outcomes as respectively A and B. Jab bhi first time spin karega, uska output rahega A. Jab bhi second time spin karega, uska output rahega B. These are the outcomes respectively. What is the probability that the fraction A by B, first time the number, jis number ke upar ek khada rahega, O number divided by second time, the number. So we can obtain the fractions. So say for example, in the first spin, suppose this arrow comes at 2. So then A is equal to 2. Next time it comes at 4, B is equal to 4. So A by B is 2 by 4, 1 by 2. So this is how we can obtain the fractions. Now question is, what is the probability that the fraction A by B is less than 1, greater than 1, and A by B is equal to 1? This exercise is similar to throwing a dice having outputs 1 to 6 two times or throwing two dice at the same time simultaneously. So what are the possible outcomes? Now you must have guessed when I compare this one with the dice, because there are six outcomes here and dice also has six outcomes. So if two dice are thrown, 36 outcomes are there. Here also, if two times this is the player spins the arrow two times, and therefore the possible outcomes are 36 outcomes. So let me list down A on one side, B on one side. So total number of solution, total number of all possible outcomes is equal to S is equal to, here this is A and here this is B. Here I'll write B. Yeah, A can be from 1 to 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I think I require a space there. First I list down all possible outcomes and then write it. Here we'll make it A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is B here. So this is all total possible outcomes. What are these things here? A and B, let me list down. So 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. A first, always first represents A, second represents B. See, these are called ordered pairs. So what are these called? Ordered pairs. Ordered pairs are nothing but these are coordinates of in a coordinate geometry. These are nothing but the points, the coordinates of the point, x coordinate and y coordinate, something like that, because those are also ordered pairs. Ordered pairs, if I change the order, those are not equal. For example, 2 comma 3 is not equal to 3 comma 2. Please remember that, because these are ordered pairs. A alag hai, A alag hai. Suppose if I give these coordinates, would you be able to point, if you plot these two points, both the points are totally different, and hence the ordered pair will not be, ordered pairs will not be equal. Anyway, that is an additional information, keep it in mind. So here the ordered pairs formed by spinning the pointer two times gives us all possible outcomes, total number of possible outcomes. So 1 1 ho gaya, next 2 1, 2 2, 2 3, probability that A by B should be less than 1. First one, let event A be the one where the outcomes are A by B less than 1. So let me list down all these outcomes for event A, which is AB A by B less than 1. So N of A I'll calculate directly without listing. From that I'll calculate N of A. A by B should be less than 1. Matlab, A should be greater than 1. So A by B is less than 1 implies A should be greater than B. A by B should be less than, 1 minute. Ulta bol raha hu main. First one, A by B should be less than 1. A by B is less than 1 if A is smaller than B. Correct or not? Denominator should be greater. So can you select those numbers where A is smaller than B always? In that case, इफ ए इज स्मॉलर देन बी देन ए बाई बी विल बी स्मॉलर देन वन. ये समझ में आ गया आपको. इफ डिनोमिनेटर इज ग्रेटर देन द न्यूमरेटर देन द फ्रैक्शन विल बी लेस देन वन. फॉर विच आई शुड सेलेक्ट सच ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स वेयर द वैल्यू ऑफ ए शुड बी लेस देन बी. इजंट इट. देखो अभी द डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स 1 1 2 2 3 3 4 4 5 5 6 6. यू चेक द डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स हियर. ओके. या डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स छोड़ दो, लीव दैट. हियर ए इज स्मॉलर, बी इज ग्रेटर देन. ए स्मॉलर, 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 ए स्मॉलर. हियर ऑल्सो स्मॉलर, 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 एंड ऑल्सो हियर स्मॉलर. सो ऑल दीज सेट्स और ऑल दीज ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द डायगोनल आर द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स वेयर ए इज स्मॉलर देन बी. करेक्ट और नॉट? काउंट इट, हाउ मेनी आउटकम्स आर देयर. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15. आ रहा है समझ में? एंड देयर फोर एन ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू 15. डायरेक्टली आई एम राइटिंग फ्रॉम देयर. एंड देयर फोर प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एंड ऑल्सो एन ऑफ एस लिख देंगे. एन ऑफ एस ऑल पॉसिबल आउटकम्स 36. देयर फोर प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ए बाई बी लेस देन 1 इज इक्वल टू एन ऑफ ए डिवाइडेड बाई एन ऑफ एस. N of A, which is N of A is how much? 15 divided by 36. Therefore, P of A by B less than 1 is equal to 5 divided by 12. 3 5s are 3 12s are. Is it clear? Okay, next. Second one. Probability that, or I'll write, let B be the event where A by B is greater than 1. So, number of outcomes favorable for event B where if the fraction is greater than 1 is given by A by B is greater than 1 if A is greater than B. If the numerator is greater than the denominator, then the fraction will be more than 1. So, check below here. Greater, A greater, A greater, A greater, A greater, A greater, A greater. In the ordered pair, the first fraction is, the first number is A, second number is B. So, check here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Once again, there are 15 outcomes where the fraction A by B is greater than 1. And therefore, n of b is equal to 15. Therefore, probability of getting b is equal to n of b divided by n of s, which is equal to 15 divided by 36, which is 5 by 12. Again, samajh mein? Next, third category, a by b is equal to 1. That means, let c be the event where the fraction a by b is equal to 1. So, n of c is equal to, here, a by b is equal to 1 if a equals b. So, which are the outcomes a is equal to b? All these diagonal elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 outcomes which are favorable for a by b equals 1. And therefore, probability of c is equal to n of c divided by n of s, which is 1 by 6. I hope you have understood. This is a very typical sum, and last year only this question had asked, but we can expect the other two questions also, greater than 1 and this one. Make a note of this one. Just students, one small correction here. It is a small correction. When I writing the coordinates, I have taken B as a first coordinate and then A here, because you know, here you check it, 2 is this side. I have selected from B, 2 I have selected. So first coordinate is B and next is A. Therefore, whatever that I have solved, always I have taken the first coordinate as A, and therefore I will change this to A here and this to B here. Now everything is correct. So if I make this one as A, then it is correct. This is A here, 2, A here, 3, A here, 4, A is 5, A is 6. Now it is correct. So what I did here changed, just remind to remind you, I changed A on this side and B on this side. Otherwise everything remains same. So that I can read first coordinate as greater. A is a greater here. I mean even if you take that way also, the answer will not change. Only for your information, A is this side, B is that side. What else? Another one or two numericals are there. I think I discussed about 8 numericals. What is the time now? Almost 1 hour we have crossed it. Let me see if one more sum is there. Let me try to take, or I'll end the lecture here. A typical sum: a letter is selected at random from the word probability. Find the probability of selecting a vowel and a consonant. So total number of letters one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Number of vowels. One, two, three, four. There are four vowels, and therefore probability of getting vowels is equal to 4 divided by 11. What about probability of getting consonants? Consonants is equal to 1 minus probability of vowels. Remaining will be consonants, no? 1 minus 4 by 11, which is 11 minus 4 divided by 11, which is equal to 7 plus 3, 1, 7 by 11. This is note of this. One more typical sum: offices in Delhi are open for 5 days in a week, that is Monday to Friday. Two employees of an office remain absent for 1 day in a particular week. Find the probability that they remain absent on the same day, consecutive day, and different days. Very typical sum. See here, 5 days in a week are working days, and two employees can remain in those working days as absent. One employee can remain absent out of 5 days any day. Similarly, second employee can also be absent out of any of the 5 days. So what are the total combinations of all the days that each one can remain absent? 5 for one employee, for second employee another 5 days. So 5 by 5 matrix is prepared. So 5 square, which is 25 number of days are available, on which the 25 days of combinations are available, on which the two employees can remain absent. So I'll write here the solution: two employees can remain absent for two employees can remain absent amongst 5 into 5, which is equal to 25 days. Out of 25 days, these two employees can be absent on any of the days. Do you understand? I don't know whether you are able to understand here. See here, employee 1 and employee 2, or maybe employee 1 I'll write here, employee 2 here. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, that's all, 5 days. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So there are 5 possibilities for him and there are 5 days for him. So what is the combination that they can be absent? The combination of absent: he can be on Monday, he also can be on Monday. He can be on Monday, this fellow can be on Tuesday. Monday, Wednesday, Monday, Thursday, Monday, Friday. This is how the total possible combinations for both the employees to remain absent is 25 days. You got it? So two employees can remain absent amongst 25 days, available 25 days. Therefore, total number of possible outcomes. Therefore, total number of possible outcomes is equal to 25. Next is here, first, on the same day, let event A equals absent on the same day. Absent on same day. So therefore A is equal to absent on same day means out of the week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. That's all, isn't it? Therefore they can be remain absent on same day, matlab Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 days are available. And therefore, N of A equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. And therefore, probability of A, that is absent on the same day, is equal to N of A divided by N of S. N of S, either lick that down, this 25, total number of outcomes is equal to N of S. Is equal to 25 square, and this is N of A by N of S is 5 divided by 25, which is 1/5. Check the answer for okay, it is correct. Second part on consecutive day, that means they can be absent on, if one is absent on Monday, the other should be on Tuesday. So the combinations I'll write it. Second one, consecutive day, let event B equals absent on consecutive day. So let me list down the elements of this set. Monday, Tuesday, correct? Both are possible. If Monday, Tuesday, then Tuesday, Monday also is possible. First employee can be on Monday, second on Tuesday, or first employee can be on Tuesday, second can be on Monday. This is first combination. Next, Monday, Tuesday, Tuesday, Monday. Okay. Now, Tuesday, Wednesday, WD, I'll write. Tuesday, Wednesday, or Wednesday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Thursday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, or Friday, Thursday. Any other combination? Because Friday, Saturday, it is not possible. Those are not consecutive days. Or Saturday, Sunday are being holidays, Friday and Monday are not consecutive days. We cannot take that combination. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I could find only 8 possible options. And therefore, N of B is equal to 8. And therefore, probability of B is equal to N of B divided by N of S, which is 8 divided by 25. That is the answer for this. Third one, on different days, one minus probability on the same day. Simple. Therefore, let C be the event on different day. They remain absent on different day. So probability of C is equal to 1 minus probability of A here, event A is absent on same day, which is equal to 1 minus 1/5, which is equal to 5 minus 1/5, which is 4/5. Check that answer, 4/5. So this is how we can calculate the probabilities See, dear students, I have taken some of the typical example sums from R.D. Sharma, R.S. Agarwal, and some more ICSE couple of problems. So make a note of all these things. If any queries, please get back to me. So let me end the chapter over here as well as the lecture over here for probability. So see you in the next class, in the next lecture with a new chapter. Thank you very much for watching.